Incompetent and spiteful, Peter Dutton unleashes an extraordinary attack on former PM Malcolm Turnbull.
A mother has drowned trying to save a child. She's the seventh person to drown in 1 week. Now, the new plan to save lives.
Andrew Johns collapses on holiday as the rugby league legend opens up about his private health battle.
The big heat and the big wet, extreme weather continues around the country. We have your New Year forecast.
The overseas hotspots for Aussie travellers next year and how to get a cheap deal now. From the Thai cave rescue to the royal wedding, our favourite good news stories from this year.
And party like it's 2019, your guide to all the best New Year's Eve celebrations around the country.
Good morning and welcome to Sunday, the 30th of December. Thanks for your company, Dougal. Alice, good morning. One more day and the year is kaput.
I know. Where's the time gone? It's already 2019. I can't believe 2018 is over. That is incredible,
isn't it? Means you've got to party like it's no tomorrow. Tomorrow night, right? Have you got plans?
I've got plans. I've got a barbecue planned, but I don't think I'm going to keep a lid on it this year.
Really?
Past years, it's been...
This is a crime because Dougal has a baby due next
year. This is your last chance,
Dougal. It's the last time he gets to party. You've got the designated driver.
Yeah,
and you're keep
I'm drinking
a lid
for
on
two.
It?
No, I'm drinking for two. I'm drinking for two because my mates have got babies now and they are showing an entirely different side of themselves.
They've grown up and they've matured.
The beer bongs have gone. They're not doing any of that anymore. And all of a sudden, it's like responsible, 12 o'clock, they all turn into pumpkins.
At least they make it to 12 o'clock. You don't even make it to that hour at my house.
You got to put a little bit of effort in. But, you know, these guys, I'm selling them a little bit short. If they just, you know, once the beer touches their lips, maybe they might just turn into something
they
else.
They might go a bit crazy. Look, you've got one more year, so you've got to get in and make it count.
Because hopefully.
Your life is over after
Don't say that. It's beginning.
Your partying life is over.
Okay.
Yeah, this is it. Okay, let's get some news. Good morning, Alice.
Good morning and good morning to you at home. We begin in Canberra this morning where, in an extraordinary attack on the former Prime Minister, Peter Dutton has ripped into Malcolm Turnbull, calling him incompetent and spiteful. For more on this, we're joined now by Nine's political reporter, Jonathan Kersley. Jono, good morning. It was certainly explosive. What else has Mr. Dutton had to say about the ex-PM? The drama continues in Canberra. Thank you, Jono.
The Victorian government is set to introduce new measures to keep swimmers safe after a mother died trying to save her daughter in the state's east. She's the fifth person to drown in the state in just 6 days. Reid Butler has more on this from Melbourne. Reid, good morning. They are terrible stats for the start of summer. So what will these changes involve? Let's hope those changes in Victoria make a difference. Reid, thank you.
Well, police are on the hunt for a handbag thief following a spate of violent robberies in Brisbane South. In the space of just 1 hour, four women were attacked and robbed of their bags in Coopers Plains and Sunnybank. One woman was walking in an underground car park when she was pushed from behind, the man running off with her belongings. The man is described as being of African appearance and was last seen getting into a dark-coloured Audi station wagon with New South Wales registration. A new gang of youths with members as young as 14 have been linked to a spate of robberies and brawls in Melbourne's northwest and Bayside. Police fear the young members, who call themselves the Blood Drill Gang, are becoming increasingly violent in the lead up to New Year's Eve. Many of the group's young members are the brothers or family members of those associated with more hardcore gangs. A second person is now gone missing in floodwaters in Queensland as a severe weather warning is issued for the state's far north. Emergency services are desperately searching for a man who disappeared early this morning in Cairns and also a mother of two who went missing near Cooktown 4 days ago. It comes amid growing fears about a cyclone developing over the Coral Sea, which has the potential to hit the Cape York Peninsula this morning.
Rugby league immortal Andrew Johns has collapsed in a coffee shop on Friday after suffering a seizure. The Origin great has now revealed he's undergoing treatment and has been dealing with the health battle privately for several years. For more, we're joined by Dr. Brad McKay. Dr. Brad, good morning. We're not going to pretend we know the ins and outs of Andrew Johns' health battle at the moment, but what is a seizure and why do people suffer from them?
Yeah, about 1% of the population in Australia have epilepsy and they deal with it every day of their life. There are some amazing medication that can keep everything under control, so that's one of the good things about it. but it's also that routine in your schedule and getting enough sleep.
Okay, I thought certainly with Andrew and his family today, let's hope he's getting the help that he needs. Dr. Brad, thank you very much.
Cheers.
Well, now for a cool change. I think we all need this after the heat that's been sweeping the country. Cool. A group of animals at a wildlife park have enjoyed playtime in the snow in China's northeast. Pandas, deer and yaks ran and tumbled in the fresh powder. Some even enjoyed some icy treats. However, some creatures were less than impressed, yes it is, no, with the snowfall, like this emu, who obviously usually prefers Australia's hot, dry conditions.
That's not right.
He was very much out of place there, wasn't he?
I have never seen an emu in snow.
No, oh, look at that panda. Look at him. Look at him go.
I don't think that emu would have ever seen snow.
No. That poor, like, we're fascinated by an animal whose natural habitat is snow, a panda, and yet I'm more interested in why that poor emu is in the snow.
He's just like, get me out of here. What am I doing?
Send me back home, please.
Yeah. Now let's take a look at the weather today with Davina.
No snow, I can tell you that for sure. That poor emu better head to Brisbane. Partly cloudy, 31 degrees. Gold Coast, you're looking mostly fine with a top of 29 on the way. In Sydney, sunny and 32 degrees. Canberra, there is the chance of a shower developing after a top of 35 degrees. In Melbourne, you're set for showers as well and 23 degrees. Hobart, partly cloudy, a top of 23 as well. Adelaide, mostly sunny, reaching 28 degrees. Perth, sunny and 28. Alice Springs, geez, it's been hot. There were records broken yesterday and you're on track again today, 44 degrees. And in Darwin, a shower or two, there is the chance of a storm as well and 33 degrees. Well, that is how today is looking around the country. Let's have a look at how tomorrow and more importantly tomorrow night is looking. We're joined by meteorologist Jonathan Howe from the Bureau of Meteorology. Jonathan, good morning. Most of Australians have had some pretty extreme weather this last week. Is it going to be unpredictable tomorrow night? What should we be bracing for or expecting?
Yeah, at this stage, it's going to take a similar path to what Owen did. So it's most likely going to form in the Gulf of Carpentaria and then track back towards east over the Coral Sea. And at this stage, from about Wednesday, Thursday, there is a bit of uncertainty as to how it will track, with some models bringing it closer to the coast. But in terms of those inland Queensland parts that really need the rain, unfortunately, the guidance isn't showing us that it's going to kind of get into that inland part. So at this stage, it's really only coastal locations where they get the most rain. And at this stage, yeah, looking like to be likely to be some flooding as well.
Okay, we'll keep an eye on that. Jonathan Howe from the Bureau, thank you so much. Well, fireworks are a way to celebrate and ring in the new year, but we've got to admit, for our four-legged friends, they can be pretty terrifying.
Yeah, the RSPCA reports an increase in the number of lost dogs and pets that are injured in the days following New Year's Eve. So to help us take care of our furry friends, and there's one in the studio right now, I'm joined by a vet, Dr. Josie Golan. Josie, first of all,
who are you joined with?
Who's this?
This is Albus. Morning,
Hi,
guys.
Albus,
this is his first time on telly and his first time on a swivel chair, so he's a bit confused.
So proud
little baby, but he's happy to be here.
What is he?
He's a Hungarian Vizsla.
Oh, okay, they're very in vogue at the moment, aren't they?
Yeah, and he's only 8 months, so he's still a baby. Okay, so he's a bit confused. Let's see if he'll just
it's
nicely.
Okay. We're not going to bite.
You're right. Good boy.
Oh,
he's
look
okay.
At him.
He's like, Mum, what are you doing?
Yeah.
It's called a thunder shirt, and you just wrap it around them.
It's just like
it
a
does look a little bit awkward like that, but yeah.
That is not how you wrap a baby.
There's instructions in the box, so you can work with it. Yeah,
no,
exactly.
You don't just strap it in.
Like that.
Exactly.
Done.
You're done. Perfect.
Easy.
Watch out for those ones too.
Go firing them at the dogs.
No, that's also not a good idea.
Need to work on this.
I'm sorry. Can you? This is Albus's segment. Albus, you're being the star of the show.
Albus, you're beautiful.
He's been very well behaved. Yeah, look at him, especially for an 8 month old.
I really did.
Tire him out. Absolutely.
You did well.
He's good all the time.
Well, thank you so much, Albus. Well done.
Yeah,
have fun, you,
Albus.
Man.
Did good.
Well, from devastating natural disasters to political scandals, 2018 has been a pretty busy year for our newsrooms.
But this morning, we want to take a moment on the reflection, I should say, of the good news stories we've had to report to you in 2018.
The one that make us happy.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Let's talk about your highlight of the year.
Oh, yeah.
Love this story.
They were so cute, the conjoined twins, Nima and Dawa. You got to cover that story.
Yeah, didn't get to cuddle them. Dr. Joe Cramery, who led the operation, he wandered out with everyone because there's this huge medical team involved. And they all wandered out and with these huge grins on their faces saying,
it was a good answer.
Yeah, we've done it.
I loved how they were separated and the surgery had gone well and yet the girls still wanted to touch each other and still be close together.
They were sleeping on with arms over one another because they had to be so close together.
Yeah.
That's what they were used to. And now we've seen these amazing pictures, of course, of them recovering and they're all kicking along, they're crawling.
by themselves.
Oh, so it's beautiful to hear, isn't it?
Yeah, it's just a sensational story.
You know, we cover so many stories where something tragic comes out of something good, and it has been such a tough year for Australian farmers right around the country, the conditions that we have never experienced before. And it's not just a drought that has lasted a week or a month. It's lasted years, and it was finally great that we saw it thrust into the national spotlight. Everyone just quickly loves a wedding, loves a baby.
Oh,
and we got two courtesy of Harry and Meghan this year well. How great was that?
The Duke and Duchess of Sussex. Mm-hmm. I think that 1.9 billion tuned into
wow.
it. What an amazing story that was. I think I don't think we can love them anymore.
No, well, the speculation was covering the baby bump.
Okay.
So
you're onto it more than I am.
Yeah, you should be onto it more than I am. You've got the bump in the household, definitely not me.
Oh, I'm bad.
Definitely not me, just in case you're wondering. happy news stories all around. None in 2019 for my family. Plenty for my family, though. So we wanted to share with you guys some of the happy, happy stories that we enjoyed so much covering this year. Coming up, though, a measles warning. An alert issued for a contagious man visiting several hot city hotspots. We'll tell you how to make sure you can protect your family, make sure you don't fall ill.
And one mum's incredible transformation that's all started with a New Year's resolution. She's an absolute inspiration. Don't miss her story.
No, that's not me. I don't break hearts.
Well, better stock up the esky and gas bottles. The New Year's Eve celebrations kick off tomorrow and end with a bang.
The countdown is on and promising to be bigger and better than ever, and it is a fight of state against state, mate against mate, right around the country to see who has the best party prepared. Let's head first to Queensland.
Oh, it's all going to go off there in Perth,
use
I think.
That is an excuse. We had Christo Tino, Madeline Slattery, Alyssa and Lysandra, and Virgo, thank you so much. We'll leave it up to you to decide who is the superior offering. What do you reckon?
Oh, yeah, we'll have to wait till midnight, I think, and then see what it all comes down
It'll
to.
It'll be staggered at least. So you do Sydney, and then you can go up to Queensland and then over to Perth. So everything's on.
Don't forget Adelaide.
Off you go.
Well, it's all come to an end, hasn't it? I think we've all had fun.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's been great fun. Great way to round out a year.
We lasted the weekend. If you hadn't noticed, none of us knew each other beforehand. We'd never done this job before. We
D
got
team.
Through the weekend and we didn't
it.
Get the sack. Yep, the D team. Thank you for joining us this morning. Happy New Year to everyone. Alice has got her first New Year's Eve in Sydney.
Yeah.
I'll be in bed.
I'll be at a barbie.
Your last barbecue
Barbie.
Before Bubby comes this time next year when you're a dad.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
It's going to be sensational.
Happy New Year, everyone.
See you, everyone. Steps twice, let the party begin.